Hi up, Rayvers. Got a British crime classic for you today as we go back to the 70s to take a look at John Thaw and Dennis Waterman in Sweeney. Sweeney, the Sweeney, do, the Sweeney, yeah, bloody love the Sweeney. It's an essential part of my daily telly watching on RTV4 these days and all. Yeah, in between the depressing cycle of adverts seemingly aimed at a target audience of coffin dodgers.
So for a dignified farewell...
You need Revitif.
And it guarantees a cash payout when you die.
I've been thinking about my funeral.
JustATrader.com. I thoroughly enjoy sitting down to watch an episode at Sweeney. Iconic theme tune and all, ain't it? But what I'm going to review today ain't the Sweeney. No, it's Sweeney! With an exclamation mark on it. Yeah, the movie version of the TV series. Don't know why they changed the title. Maybe they envisaged a gangster uttering it to his gangmates. Sweeney! You know, like a warning. Sweeney! Hey lads, Sweeney! You know, that sort of thing. Anyway, as the film kicks off, we meet Ian Bannon playing Charles Baker, some high-ranking politician who's about to speak at an important conference about oil prices or some such. Now it changes, does it? And we also meet Barry Foster as Baker's slimy American press secretary. Instantly comes across as a wrong'un. Now, whilst this conference is going on, Linda Bellingham is up in some hotel room with some suspicious-looking blokes, seemingly recording a message for Charles Baker about wanting to end it all.
I want to speak to Charles Baker.
Now, you younger ravers will probably remember Linda Bellingham as the mum from the Oxo adverts. But in the 70s, she'd frequently pop up as Totty in various things. But she seems very naive in this, Linda Bellingham. Because after she's recorded the message, the shifty-looking fellas murder her. And then they leave her in the hotel room, stripped nude, with a load of evidence to make it look like she's done herself in order to set up Baker and create a scandal so they can blackmail him.
She ruined my marriage and now she's wrecked my career. I'm finished.
No, not necessarily.
Because they're open to blackmail, aren't they, politicians? Because otherwise, they would have to resign if they're involved in a scandal. Always resign if they're involved in a scandal, politicians, don't they? Always. Yeah. Anyway, we then get the title sequence. But they don't have the classic theme tune. Instead, they've got this perfectly acceptable, funky music. But it ain't the classic theme tune, which I'm disappointed about, to be honest with you. And it looks like Regan and Carter have had a night on the pot, a bit worse for wear. Now, for my international ravers, who may not be familiar with the Sweeney, Inspector Jack Regan, played by John Thaw, and Sergeant George Carter, played by Dennis Waterman, are members of the Police Flying Squad, a branch of the Serious and Organised Crime Division in London's Metropolitan Police. And they're referred to in Cockney rhyming slang as the Sweeney. Sweeney Todd Flying Squad. And they don't waste any time with Sweeney because they get straight into a punch-up with some baddies. Oi lads, Sweeney! Now, I ain't a violent chap, but I must confess, I always enjoyed it when the Sweeney had a good scrap. Duffing folk up. Very primal.
Kick him!
Now, coincidentally, Regan's informant, who tipped him off about this robbery, well, he were also knocking off Linda Bellingham, and he don't believe the coroner's conclusion that she topped herself.
She never topped herself, Jack. She was a great girl, full of life.
Yeah, yeah.
But after he's disclosed his suspicions to Regan, some dodgy coppers bump him off. And his mate, played by Brian Glover, Mrs. Shane. And this is just one too many coincidence for Regan, so he decides to investigate. But there's obviously some sinister higher forces at work. who don't want him sticking his nose in. And he gets pulled over by these fake coppers, who then nab him and force him to drink a bottle of scotch to get him done for drink driving and kicked off the force. So the film sees Regan trying to prove his innocence whilst at the same time uncovering this high-level conspiracy.
I have reason to believe that there is a high-level conspiracy which is responsible for several so far unexplained deaths and of which I myself have been a victim.
And obviously we're supposed to feel some sympathy for Regan. Yeah, we're supposed to be on his side because he was stitched up. But the thing was, it were drink driving. We'd just seen him beforehand getting leathered with George at the pub. But I suppose this were back in the 70s when you were allowed to consume about 45 units before a breathalyzer had ping. And when he was so pissed, he was trying to chat up the barman's wife.
Sod it.
Hey, you're always good at delivering a one-liner in the Sweeney with John Thaw, weren't you?
Get your trousers on. You're nicked.
And you are in the manure, right up to your pink little ears.
Who the hell are you, the Sweeney? Watch your mouth.
Well, you can stuff it.
I reckon one of the things I love about the Sweeney is its Britishness. Very British. For example, in an American cop movie, if the hero gets caught unawares in a state of undress, he'll probably be running around with his shirt undone and his honed torso on show. But in Sweeney, when Regan gets caught off guard, he's swanning around with no trousers on.
What the bleeding hell's going on?
And maybe I'm wrong, but I don't think you'd get Morecambe and Wise cropping up in an American cop show. And that were a weird episode, that one. Don't reckon I'll ever forget the image of Eric Morecambe clambering onto the back of a van to throw boxes of frozen fish at the baddies. Seared into my brain, that one. Now, obviously, with this being a British film, there are a lot of familiar faces in it. Many of whom have appeared as police officers in other stuff. So it's time for a brand new feature. What have they been police officers in? Now, this bloke, he popped up as a chief inspector in Bill. This fella, he was Sergeant Rycott in Minder. Of course, that were also starring Dennis Waterman, weren't it? Barry Foster, he were Vandervelt. Another programme with a great theme tune, Vandervelt, weren't it? Now, I really enjoyed Vandervelt in the 70s, but me and Denise watched an episode of it recently, and it was a boring, it was crap. That's Colin Welland. He was PC David Graham in Zed Cars in the 60s, weren't he, Colin Welland? And Linda Bellingham, she popped up as an inspector in New Tricks. I think she were a copper in other things and all, but can't find any footage of them. And talking of New Tricks, of course, Dennis Waterman, he were in New Tricks, weren't he? But perhaps most famous of all, John Thaw, he were Inspector Morse, weren't he? Yeah, Inspector Morse. Now, I really enjoyed watching Morse. Thought it was very good. And to this day, I still drive round with Classic FM on, pretending I'm Inspector Morse. Because, you know, that's what he did, didn't he? But as a copper, Morse, he was shit. He always fell for the attractive female suspects, and it clouded his judgement, didn't it? And the other thing what clouded his judgement was that he spent half his time in the pub. He drank more than Jack Regan did. And more often than not, it were Lewis what solved the murders. Yeah, Lewis would just say something and Inspector Morse would go, oh, yeah, that's right, Lewis, yeah.
What did you say?
Oh, I was just introducing myself to Mr. Richard.
Just say that again. Just repeat exactly what you just said.
Clueless. Yeah, we're too busy ogling the female suspects or popping to the pub for a liquid lunch. Incidentally, John Thaw were 45 when they filmed that. Tough paper round. Now, with that level of policing experience, we can relax, safe in the knowledge that the Sweeney do everything by the book.
George, get up here, quick.
No, you listen to me.
It's all right. He's a policeman.
Without doubt, they're the epitome of professionalism. Weren't she a witness? And they foster a healthy an inclusive working environment, and they uphold the unblemished reputation of London's Metropolitan Police. So, on to Ray's ratings, and I thoroughly enjoy the Sweeney, as I've said. But, you know, spin-off films from TV programmes ain't always the best, are they? But, yeah, I were hoping for a solid three-star film. That's what I got. I enjoyed it. It felt like an extended episode at Sweeney, but without the ITV4 Coffin Dodger adverts. Don't know why they didn't have the iconic Sweeney theme tune, though. That were disappointing to me. But you did get John Thaw running around without his trousers on. So, you know, six of one, half a dozen of t'other. So I'm rating Sweeney a three-star film. Now, it was successful enough to spawn a sequel, Sweeney 2. No exclamation mark, you'll notice, this time. So it weren't Sweeney 2, it was just Sweeney 2. And if memory serves, I think they ended up going abroad, which they often used to do in movie spin-offs of TV programmes, didn't they? I mean, I say abroad, it was set abroad. But they just got some stock footage of an airport and then managed to get the backlot of Elstree Studios to double up as Costa Planca.
There's nothing like an exotic holiday abroad.
And this one out like an exotic holiday abroad. Hey, Road, it's probably about that time, isn't it? That time of day. Flick on ITV4 and watch the Sweeney. Here we go. This don't look like a Sweeney, what's this?
And they start away in the middle.
Horse racing? Oh, bloody hell. Well, I hope you enjoyed my review of Sweeney. And if you did, poke the old like button for me. Give it a good old poking. Or maybe get a sawn-off shotgun. Like one of them gangsters would do it. Go boom! And poke it that way. Maybe not, because you blow your computer up. So, yeah, don't do that, no. But, yeah, just poke it. And remember to share Rate Reviews with your mates. And subscribe to my channel if you ain't already a subscriber. Much appreciated. And thank you very much indeed for all your great comments that you keep popping on my videos. It's great. Really do appreciate it. Apologies if I don't get round to responding to them all. But keep them coming. Thank you. And copyright box permitting, I will be back with a Christmas-themed review very soon. So I will see you next time. Okeydoo!